good. I know our act two is we haven't, act one is in really good shape. Act two, we just haven't worked it as much. So we'll probably be focusing a lot of attention to act two next week.
Oh, that your highness only knew my heart in this. I have never loved my brother in my life.
More villain thou. Well, turn him out of doors and let my officers of such a nature take an extent upon his house and lands. Do this expediently and turn him going.
No jewel is like Rosalind. Her worth being mounted on the wind, through all the world bears Rosalind. All the pictures fairest lined are but black to Rosaline. Let no fair be kept in mind but the fair of Rosaline.
I'll run you so 8 years together, dinners and suppers, and sleeping hours accepted.
Was that my last thing?
For a taste. If a heart do lack a hind, let him seek out Rosaline. If the cat will after kind, so be sure will Rosaline. Winter coats must be lined, so must slender Rosaline. Mm-hmm. Sweetest nut hath sourest rind. Such a nut is Rosaline. He the sweetest rose will find must find love's prince and Rosaline. This is the very false gallop of verses. Why do you infect yourself with them?
Peace, you dull fool. I found them on a tree.
Truly, the tree yields bad fruit.
Thus, Rosalind of many parts, by heavenly sin it was devised, of many faces, eyes, and hearts, to have the touches dearest prized. Heaven would that she these gifts should have, and I to live and die her slab.
Oh, most gentle Jupiter.
Oh, how now? Back, friends. Good shepherd, why?
Go on a little.
Go with him, sirrah.
Come, shepherd. Let us make an honorable retreat. Though not with baggage, yet with scrip and scribbage.
Thou through these verses? Oh yes, I heard them all, and more too, for some of them have in them more feet than the verses would bear. But, trow you, who hath done this? Go back.
But didst thou hear how thy name came to be hanged?
I was 7 out of the 9 days of wonder before you came. For look here what I found on a palm tree.
Oh.
Trow you who have done this.
Is it a man?
And a chain that you once wore about his neck.
I prithee who?
Do you color?
I prithee who?
Is it possible?
Nay, I prithee now with most petitionary vehemence. Tell me who it is. Wonderful, oh, wonderful. Most wonderful, and yet again wonderful, and out of all whooping.
I pray, tell me who it is quickly and speed your pace.
So you may put
I pray, take the cork out of the mouth that I may drink thy tight.
So you may put a man in your belly.
What manner of a man? Is his head with the hat, or his chin with a beard?
Oh, nay, he hath but little beard.
Well, God will send more if the man will be thankful.
But let me stay the growth of his beard, if thou lady, not in the knowledge of his chin.
It is young Orlando who tripped up the wrestler's heels and your heart both in an instant.
Nay, but the devil take mocking. Speak, sad brow and true maid.
In faith, cause 'tis he.
Orlando? Alas, the day. How looked he? Where went he?
What
makes thank you?
I know the scene.
Okay. What makes him here?
Why did he
Okay, what makes him here? Did he ask for me? How far did he with me? And who else he is to him? And after me in one word!
Oh, you must borrow me Gargantua's mouth first.
We're too great for the mouth of this age's size to answer I and know it's more than to answer the catechism.
But, blind.
Doth he know?
Oh,
you
go. We added a line.
Oh, you weren't here.
But doth he know
that I am in this forest and in a man's apparel? Look to you, especially as the day you wrestled.
It is as easy to count atomies as it is to solve the propositions of a lover. Oh, but take a taste of my finding him and relish it in good observance. I found him under a tree,
like a dropped acorn.
May as well be called Joe's tree when the drops forth such fruit.
Give me audience, good madam.
Proceed.
There lay he, stretched along like a wounded knight.
Though it's a pity to see such a sight, all becomes the ground.
I haul it to thy tongue, I prithee. He was furnished like a hunter.
How ominous! He comes to kill my heart.
I would sing my song without a burden. Thou breakest me out of tune.
Do you not know that I am woman?
When I think I must speak.
Sweet.
Say on.
You bring me out.
Soft comes he not here?
Tis he. Sling by and go to.
I thank thee for your company, but good faith, I had as lief have been myself alone.
So had I, but for fashion's sake, I thank thee for thy society.
God be with you. Let's meet as little as we can.
I do desire that we be better strangers.
Oh, I pray you. Mar no more trees with writing love songs in their barks.
I pray you mar no more of my verses by reading them ill-favoredly.
Rosalind is your love's name?
Yes, just.
Yeah, I do not like her name.
There was no thought of pleasing you when she was christened.
Well, what stature is she of?
Just as high as my heart.
Oh, you're full of pretty answers.
I am weary of you.
Fine.
By my troth.
By my troth, I was looking for a fool when I found you.
Ah, he is round in the brook. Look, buddy, and you will see him.
There shall I see. Mine own figure. I'll tarry no longer with you. Farewell, good Signor Love.
I am glad of your departure. Farewell, good Monsieur Melancholy.
I will speak to him like a saucy lackey, and under this habit play the knave of him. Do you hear, Forester?
Very well. What would you?
I pray you, what is it o'clock?
You should ask me what time of day it is. There's no clock in the forest.
Then there is no true lover in the